And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Ken Slavin.
In some secluded rendezvous that overlooks the avenue, with someone sharing a delightful chat of this and that and cocktails for two, as we enjoy a cigarette to some exquisite chansonette. Two hands are sure to slyly meet beneath a serviette with cocktails for two. My head may go reeling, but my heart will be obedient with intoxicating kisses for the principal ingredient. Most any afternoon at 5, we'll be so glad we're both alive. Then maybe fortune will complete her plan that all began with cocktails for two. In some secluded rendezvous that overlooks the avenue, with someone sharing a delightful chat of this and that and cocktails for two, as we enjoy a cigarette to some exquisite chansonette. Two hands are sure to slyly meet beneath a serviette with cocktails for two. My head may go reeling, but my heart will be obedient with intoxicating kisses for the principal ingredient. Most any afternoon at 5, we'll be so glad we're both alive. Then maybe fortune will complete her plan that all began with cocktails with Ken.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, what a pleasure to be back in New York City and at the wonderful Metropolitan Room. I'm delighted. I have some wonderful friends in too, and I can't even begin to name them all, but I'm delighted to have my fraternity brother Arthur Carvajal here from Chicago. He's up from Chicago, and I think we have some folks in from San Antonio, and yes, and we have, hi, I can't even see who's over there. Who is there?
Chris.
Oh, yes, Chris Jules, hi there. Taylor, we wrote yesterday on Facebook, so glad you're here. And my goodness, just from all over, I'm delighted. I'm delighted to be with all of you here tonight. And I'd like to take a moment to introduce the wonderful musicians that will be entertaining you for the next hour or so. We have Mr. John Colianni on the piano. Frank Tate on the upright bass. And Paul Bollenback on the guitar. Our plan tonight is, I called it Cocktails with Ken, a Saloon Jazz Mixology, and that I was trying to come up with what I thought might be an entertaining title, and I wanted to kind of run the gamut mood-wise and the sorts of songs that you, through the years, that people might listen to when they're having a libation. And it can run its course from happy to sad to vengeful, and all the other things that happen when one goes to drink. But I thought I would start with a little Cole Porter.
The night is young, the skies are clear, If you'd like to go walking, dear, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delightful. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, cause so am I. It's delightful, delicious, delightful. I can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature murmuring low. Let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. And when you see me, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's delectable, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's dilemma, it's deluxe, it's delonely. Skies are clear. If you wanna go walking, dear, it is delightful, it's delicious, it is lovely. I understand the reason why you're sentimental, cause so am I. It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely. I can tell at a glance what a swell night this is for romance. You can hear dear Mother Nature a murmuring low. Please let yourself go, so please be sweet, my chickadee. When you see me, just say to me, it's delightful, it's delicious, it's deductible, it's delirious, it's dilemma, it's dilemma, it's deluxe, it's delovely.
Whenever I think of sophisticated cocktailing, I think of Cole Porter. My goodness, oh, that man could write songs and lyrics. He was unbelievably prolific and wonderful. I would be remiss at this moment, but I don't know exactly where to look as far as the cameras go, but I wanted to say hello to my mother and to all of my family down in San Antonio who are watching the live stream tonight. I got word this afternoon that KRTU Radio, the big jazz station in San Antonio, did a whole spotlight on this show at noon to get San Antonians to tune in, and I thought that was a lot of fun. So this is a first for me. I've never been streamed live, at least not in any way that I would admit. No.
soon I'll make it on home with nothing but a memory. I'm gonna make it on home with just memory. 'Cause I'm drinking again, having a martini. Yes, I'm drinking again.
Thank you very much. That song's lyrics were written by Johnny Mercer, but I guess didn't quite do them exactly as he would have on them. He probably drank rye or something like that. And I don't think I've ever had 10 martinis, but I've come close. Depending on the mood, right? Very good. This next song is one of my favorites to do down in San Antonio. And it's just got a nice feel to it, and I think you'll recognize it. It's all about some of the lighter, breezier aspects of love and romance.
Let there be you, let there be me, let there be oysters under the sea, let there be moon and occasional rain, chili con carne and sparkling champagne. Let there be birds to sing in the trees, and someone to bless me whenever I sneeze. Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove, but first of all, please, let there be love.
Thank you. nice. You're so nice. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Isn't that kind of bright and breezy and fun? The next song we're going to do is more romantic. And then, of course, the moods change throughout the evening. Very much like people in the creative arts. We have different personalities at different times of the day and night. At least I've been told that, but, you know, what do therapists know? No, this is one of my favorite romantic songs, where we give a little bit of a Latin treatment to it. It's a song I recorded on my CD, one of my CDs a few years ago. I think you'll recognize it. It was actually a song probably made most famous by Frank Sinatra, but it's just a classic. It's called You Go to My Head.
That you might give a thought to my flame casts a spell over me, and I say to myself, get a hold of yourself. Can't you see this never can be? You go out to my head with a smile that makes my temperature rise like a summer with a thousand Julys. You intoxicate my soul with your eyes, though I'm certain that this heart of mine hasn't a ghost of a chance in this crazy romance. You go to my head.
Thank you very, very much. I think that's a very appropriate song when we're talking about cocktailing. You never know. I mean, in researching songs for this show, you know, you could end up, I mean, it's not that we're not going to do a couple of maudlin ones, because I'm sure we will. But it's amazing how they run the gamut, and some use, you know, cocktails and drinking as metaphors, and others are literal, and some are so sad and like so sad that I didn't want to sing them, and then although I sort of did, but you know, after a while, if you do like 14 sad songs, all of a sudden you're singing alone and there's nobody with you and you have to order another drink. Yeah. So we tried to mix it up, but I think it was, I thought it was amazing in studying lyrics just how often alcohol plays a part, you know. So I guess I shouldn't have been surprised after being in jazz for 25 years, but I was a little bit. This song, for me, I make a joke of it in San Antonio. I was talking earlier about mood swings. This is kind of a mood swing love song, and it kind of sums me up to a T, I think.
Sometimes I'm happy, sometimes I'm blue. You know my disposition all depends on you. Oh, I never mind all the rain from the skies, as long as I can find the love light in your eyes. Sometimes I love you, and sometimes I hate you. But when I hate you, it's because I love you. That's how I am. So what can I do? I'm happy when I'm with you. Oh, sometimes I'm happy, and sometimes disposition, it depends on you, and I never mind all the rain from the skies, just as long as I can see the love light in your eyes. Sometimes I love you, sometimes I hate you. But when I hate you, it's because I really love you. That's how I am. Oh my, so what can I do? I'm happy when I'm with you. I'm so happy when I'm with you.
I think Paul says, yeah, Ken, I think he understands that equilibrium issue. But it's amazing what lithium can do. I'm kidding. I'm glad you thought that was funny, Barry. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, my music director for tonight's show is Barry Brake. He's sitting over here. We're going to hear from him in a little while. Barry has been with me here three times out of the four times at the Metropolitan Room. He came with me the first time to record and produce my live CD of the experience here when we were here on Halloween night 2 years ago, 2013. I made my debut on Halloween night. I said, is that good luck or bad luck? I'm going to make it good luck, because Bernie Firshpan took a chance on a guy from San Antonio. And John Lombardi, the radio host who's sitting up here with City World Radio, he told Bernie about me. And we literally, I'm not kidding you, this is the electronic age we live in. I got an email from John Lombardi saying, write to Bernie Firshpan on Facebook. He's in Israel, but he'll answer you. So I wrote him, and Bernie wrote me back and said, consider yourself booked, I've already heard you. When I get back to the States, get in touch with me and we'll set a date. So we looked at dates, and then all of a sudden it was Halloween. But I could not be more grateful, because I always dreamed of singing in New York. It only took 23 years, and I was 52 when I finally did it. But you know what? Isn't that great? Yeah. And I just, it's just so much fun. You know, I'm the kind of person that could sing forever in this room. I could just stand here and sing 78 songs, you know? Of course, everybody would leave, like I said, and then I'd really know the meaning of the songs I'm performing tonight. This is a song that was made famous by the late Ray Charles. And I would like to also say that I heard a beautiful version by Peggy Lee, and it inspired me to do it tonight. Just for a thrill, you'd turn the blue sky to red. Just for a thrill, you filled my heart. To you, I was merely a toy, a plaything that you could toss around at will. This one I'm gonna start snapping whatever you want to do. This is that one that's the medley. Yes, these next two songs are ones that I like to spotlight as being among the most wonderful vengeful songs. Seeking revenge and telling the person you sought revenge that you're really, really happy that it happened. Because we've all been there. We've all been there, right? I know you have been. I can tell on your face. No, I'm kidding. We've all had this, but these songs are so terrific. The first one was made famous and was a big hit for Tony Bennett. And the second one was a hit for my favorite female pop singer from the 50s, Connie Francis. And we put them together like this. Be around to pick out the pieces when somebody breaks your heart. Somebody twice as smart as I. A somebody who will swear to be true like you used to do with me. Who'll leave you to learn that misery loves company? Wait and see. I wanna be around to see how he does it when
he breaks your heart to bits. Let's see if the puzzle fits. So fine. And that's when I'll discover revenge is sweet. While I sit there applauding from a front row seat, when somebody breaks your heart like you broke mine. Who's sorry now? Who's sorry now? Oh, whose heart is aching? For breaking each vow. Who is sad and blue? Who's crying too? Just like I cried over you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I send those out to Tony and to Connie with great regard, and I think they're wonderful songs. And I hadn't thought of putting them together until we were planning this show. I think they work well together, don't you? I think it's a lot of fun. Yeah. Thank you. Well, I tell people when I'm performing in Texas that I think this is one of the ultimate saloon songs. I mean, the title right away, the first line, tells you what it's about. But the real meaning of the song is that even without drinking, the person singing it could be just so high because he or she is so in love with the person. It's really very nice. I think you'll see that.
Soda, mud in your eye. Baby, do I feel high? Oh, me, oh my. Do I feel high? Dry martini. Jigger of gin. Oh, what a spell you've got me in. Oh, my. Do I feel high? People don't believe me. They think that I'm just bragging, but I could feel just the way I do and still be on the wagon. All I need is one of your smiles, sunshine of your eyes. Oh, me, oh my. Do I feel higher than a kite can fly? Give me a loving, baby. I feel so high. Sunshine of your eyes, oh me, oh my. Do I feel higher than a kite can fly? Give me loving, baby. I said, give me.
Thank you very much. Wonderful solo, Paul. Thank you. This next song is so pretty, and it's perfect for a room like this with the candlelight, wine, spirits. See what you think.
Moments like this make me thrill. Careless moments like this, close to you, nonchalantly, we dive and we dance. Yet my heart seems to melt in your glance. Sweet moments like this, with a soft light aglow, make me long for soft lights aglow. I long for your kiss, though I know I'll be just one of your affairs. But at moments like this, who cares? Oh, who cares? I don't care.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, I'm going to start this off with our wonderful bass man, Frank Tate. Some of you may not know this, but Frank worked with Bobby Short at the Cafe Carlyle for 10 years. Great player. I'm so lucky when I come to New York that I get to work with wonderful players like this. It's an amazing thing for a singer to be able to work with a band like this. I think they sound absolutely fantastic, and I want to give them a round.
Close your eyes, rest your head on my shoulder and sleep. Close your eyes, and I will close mine. Close your eyes, let's pretend that we're both counting sheep. Close your eyes, oh, this is divine. Music plays, something dreamy for dancing while we're romancing. It's love's holiday, and love will be our guide. Close your eyes. When you open them, dear, I'll be here by your side. Close your eyes. Yes, close your eyes. Rest your head on my shoulder and sleep. Close your eyes, and I will close mine. Ooh, close your eyes. Let's pretend that we're both counting sheep. Close your eyes. Oh, this is divine. Music play, something dreamy for dancing while we're here romancing. It's love's holiday, and love will be our guide. Close your eyes. When you open them, dear, I'll be here by your side. But close your eyes. I close your eyes. I close your eyes. I close your eyes. Oh, close your eyes.
Thank you. This next song I have been wanting to do. I have not done it in public before. I've been singing it in the shower, though, which is where I always seem to warm up my... Oh. Well, thank you. No, believe me, navy blue suits cut the right way hide a lot of things, like the fact that I weigh 700 pounds. I have a body girdle on. It starts right below the collar. goes to the knees. My goodness, after 2 hours in a club, you go home and you just kind of cut it off, you know, and it's like, oh my goodness. No, I always sing, anyway, I think all of us like to sing in the shower because of the beautiful acoustics. Nothing sounds bad with the tile. But I like to warm up before gigs when I'm getting ready, and I'll shave and shower and get dressed and stuff, listening to songs maybe that I want to learn to do. And this is one that I discovered a few years ago, and I had completely forgotten about it. But when I started researching what I thought would be good material for tonight, this one popped up, and it came to mind that I thought it would be really pretty. It's not about cocktails or anything like that, but it's about someone wishing for a love that has gone away. And the title is called Where Love Has Gone. And Barry, help me remember, it's written by, is it Sammy Kahn and Jules Stein? Yeah, Jules Stein and Sammy Kahn. Oh, I'm sorry, Jimmy Van Heusen. It was nominated for an Academy Award in 1964 for a movie called Where Love Has Gone. The movie wasn't a big hit, but the song was, and the song was recorded by Jack Jones. But I was listening to some Bobby Darin records and came across his version of it and thought it was beautiful. So I thought I would hope that you would indulge me in doing a song that I've not done before and see what you think of it. I think it's just beautiful. Isn't that pretty? So, I thought it was so wistful, and Actually, the first time I heard it, it brought tears to my eyes. I just think it's such a pretty song, and I'm surprised it's not done more, but I'm going to start, after that reaction, I'm going to start incorporating it into my shows in Texas. So thank you very much. This next song was made famous. Well, I don't know how famous it was, really, but it was a very, very successful album that Nat King Cole recorded in the early 60s. I think it came out in 1962. And I'm forgetting, once again, who the composer and lyricist is. It's been Van Heusen again. Well, no wonder. I seem to be leaning toward Van Heusen songs. But it's beautiful. And this one definitely has... I want you to imagine yourselves, you're in a place like this, or maybe a smaller little bar, you know, somewhere in Midtown Manhattan, and it's 1:30 in the morning, and there's an elegant but... lonely-looking person sitting at the bar, and you overhear this conversation between this person and, you know, perhaps the bartender or someone sitting next to him or her. It's nice to know that you recognize me. Your face looks quite familiar to me. It's great to hear that someone remembers how wonderful it all used to be. Well, pal, if you wanna listen, I'm in the mood for reminiscing. Remember how I'd walk in, what excitement there would be every time I made my entrance. Everyone would stare at me. They all would line up like a parade. Everyone loved me. I had it made. Champagne and plenty of it. Real imported caviar. Just for kicks, I'd burn a 50 when I'd light someone cigar. I kept them laughing. Jokes by the yard. Everyone loved me. I was a card, and I had a girl, a beautiful girl. Her whole world, I think, revolved around mink and diamonds and pearls. Because she was mine, how I'd glitter and shine, and life was a ball, and wasn't it all just cozy? And if I but nothing lasts forever, and I've had a darn good run. Just because I'm no longer young doesn't mean I have to cry. I'll take that nightcap. One more won't shine. And tell me, mister, maybe no. Wait. Oh, thank you. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. It's 10:30. Oh my goodness. Okay, I better speed things up. Okay. Tell you what. Let's do this next tune, and then I'm gonna have Barry up to do a song. I'm very sorry. I could, like I said, I could just go on and on. I'm very sorry. I'm getting close to the end here, but we still have time for a couple of more, right, Bernie? Is that okay?
Is it an earthquake or simply a shock? Is it the good turtle soup or is it merely the mock? Is it a cocktail, this feeling of joy? Or is what I feel the real McCoy? Is it for all time or simply a lark? Is it Granada I see or only Asbury Park? Is it a fancy not worth thinking of? Or is it a long last love? Now, is it an earthquake, or is it simply a shock? Is it the good turtle soup, or is it merely the mock? Is it a cocktail, this feeling of joy? Or is what I feel Granada I see, or only Asbury Park? Is it a fancy not worth thinking of? Or is it a long last love? Or is it a long last love?
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. At this time, I'm going to have Barry come up. We're going to switch out pianists for a moment. I couldn't have Barry fly all the way up here and help me put together this show and not be able to show off his talent as well. Last time I was here, we did this song, and we're going to do it again tonight. It's beautiful. He wrote it just for me, and it's a perfect title because I gave him the title when I was in a really, really dark mood one day. I said, you need to write me a song with a title called Bitter. Party of One. Heather was here last time when we did it. I think she liked that one. Yeah, it's called Bitter Party of One. And so he really, I think he was very surprised at the title, but he saw that there could be some real possibilities with it. And he worked on it for about a year, and he wrote a beautiful melody, and he wrote some really great lyrics. And it's well-suited to singers who work in cabaret and in bars and things like that. And I'm hoping to, I will be recording it when I finally do a whole album of this kind of material we're doing tonight. I plan to do a whole album dedicated to saloon and torch music like this. And we'll do this song, and I hope you'll like it, and I'm sure you will, and I know you'll love Barry's playing as well. Bitter Party of One. Words and music by Mr. Barry Brake.
Singing of lover songs, singing though my heart belongs to no one now, I'm forever lonely. You can call me bitter, parting one. Broke some hearts along the way. Broke some hearts and yet today this player's done. No more cards and no game. And my new name is Bitter.
Barry Brake. Stand up and take a bow, Barry. That wonderful? Very nice, Barry. Thank you. Thank you. All righty, we're going to continue. Bernie's going to let us go a little over. Thank you.
He said we could go till 1 a.m.
Perfect. And the doors have been locked and you can't leave. Isn't that great? And Heather has to go to work in the morning, right? In New Jersey. That's right. I'm exhausted. I can only sing another 66 songs. But we've got a few more here, and we're delighted. You are a beautiful audience, and I'm just delighted. And I'm hoping folks back in San Antonio are watching this. I'm having a ball, an absolute ball, working with these wonderful people. It's definitely earlier there. They're up, and I bet you a couple of my friends are having some martinis while they watch. I know of one friend in Houston. I told her to do that because she and I like to drink them together. Roseanne, I hope, is drinking a martini. Maybe having some popcorn or something. Why not? I do martinis and hamburgers all the time. Okay. In fact, this goes out to my friends in Texas because I wanted to... within this genre that I was trying to explore tonight... there are some wonderful, wonderful songs that were written in the country western tradition, written by country western artists. This one was written by Don Gibson, and many artists have recorded it, including Roy Orbison, and, Ronnie Millsap, and lots of people. And it's a really pretty song, I think, and we were going to give it a little country-politan feel for you tonight.
If heartaches brought fame in love's crazy game, I'd be a legend in my town. If they gave gold statuettes for tears and regrets, I'd be a legend. but they don't give awards, and there's no praise or fame for a heart that's been broken over love that's in vain. If loneliness meant world acclaim, then everyone would know my name. I'd be a legend in my time. But they don't give awards, and there's no praise or fame for a heart that's been broken over love that's in vain. If loneliness meant world acclaim, then everyone would know my name. I'd be a legend.
Touch of the West for you here in New York. I love that song, and it can be done in a million different ways. Pop, country, jazz. I really, really like it, and you guys played it beautifully. It was sort of like singing with Floyd Kramer there for a minute. It was a wonderful sound. Yes. Now, this is definitely a song that goes with the various moods of saloon music. I think one of the nicest versions that I've ever heard was by Nancy Wilson. Then I'm gonna laugh so hard. you. Well, this song is my traditional closing number, and I'll tell you why. A lot of you I have not met before. Some of you I know. And so I tell the story. It's my good luck charm. It's a very unusual song. It's become a jazz standard, but oddly so, because it's full. Yes, and I'm now going to dance. Like Liza! Liza! Oh my goodness. And when I first started singing, it was 1990. I just had my 25th anniversary. I started when I was 29 years old. And the first song I ever sang in public was on the San Antonio Riverwalk at a funky little place down on the Riverwalk. I like to tell people it's an elegant establishment, but its name is Dick's Last Resort, so you can only imagine. Yeah. The folks in San Antonio know this. Okay. Absolutely, I see you, Mike. And yes, you went there more than once with Dee Dee, I'm sure of it. I used to go there with her every week. In fact, I think you went with us to see me sing there, yeah. But it's a very crazy place. Shorts, flip-flops. It's a tourist hangout. It's a lot of beer, and literally they put condoms and inflate them on tops of drinks and all that stuff. And I would come walking in a suit and tie, and listen to the music, you know, after work. And I got to know the band after about a year, and I got the courage up to tell the band leader, a friend of mine, George Prado in San Antonio, that I wanted to sing a song. And he said, "Really? What do you want to sing?" I said, "Mac the Knife." And he said, "Can you sing?" I said, "Yes, I can." And he goes, "Okay." And I said, "And don't forget, I want to do all the key changes the way Bobby Darin does it." He said, "Really?" I said, "Yes." So I got up there, I sang the song. I know I missed some notes and things, but I had a ball. And the audience really liked it. They went nuts. So every Wednesday night for about another year, I would go, I'd get up and sing that song and sit down. And I would call my family, my friends, I would fill tables. I'd get up and do this one song and sit down. And one day there was a writer for a local newspaper there who saw me do this, and he wrote a column and said, "Mackie's back at Dick's Last Resort." No, "Mackie's back, Slavin croons at Last Resort." And from there I started getting professional gigs. It was crazy. So, it's my good luck charm, and I'm going to sing it for you to close out our show. It's called Mac the Knife.
Oh, the shark has pretty teeth, dear.
Yeah.
And it shows them pearly whites. But just a jackknife has old Mackie, babe. And he keeps it, yes, he keeps it out of sight. You know when that shark bites, with his teeth, dear, those scarlet billows, oh, start to spread. But fancy gloves, though, wears old Mackie, baby. So there's never, never a trace of red on the sidewalk. Ooh, Sunday morning,
yeah.
There lies a body, it's oozing life. And someone sneaking around the corner. Could that someone be Mac Knife? There's a tugboat, it's down. Dropping down. Well, that cement is only there for the weight, dear. Five will get you 10. Mackie's back in town. A Louis melody disappeared, babe, right after drawing out all his cash. Lahilenia, sweet, losing breath. out at Mac Ings. Back in time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ken Slavin.
Thank you so very much. John Colianni on the piano. John Colianni. Frank Tate on the bass. Paul Bollenback on the guitar. Also Barry Brake on piano and music director. And I'm Ken Slavin. Thank you very, very much. And Happy New Year to you all. Thank you. Beautiful people, and thank you everybody for coming out tonight. What a wonderful, wonderful time we had. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. He's parked on the curb.
If you're parked in front, you have 6 minutes.